Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's start the custom campaign, Kampf der Titanen. A German Ferdinand heavy tank destroyer campaign. And yeah, there will be no real combat in this episode. I will introduce you into the campaign. And then we will start with the first mission, which is a training mission, and familiarize ourselves. I put the link to the campaign into the description. You can find it on the EL2 forums. Make sure to download the campaign, but also the story and readme PDF. I have it here open, and it seems to be probably the best quality campaign from the first glance I could find. I really like stuff like this, also in combat mission, when campaign designers go one step further and put a lot of historical research into the situation, into the tactics used. And yeah, from this I can tell somebody put a lot of love into this campaign. Only 8 missions. I won't read it right now here on this stream. But I will go through it. And you can pause the video if you want to acquire information. I will read it for myself off stream. Semi-historical. And it is focusing on the Kursk operation, Zitadelle, Unternehmen Zitadelle. Yeah, that is really nice quality. Yeah, every mission has also introduction. We will start with a training mission. Yeah, as many of those tanks that was sent into action ASAP. Yeah, what you see here is an interesting skin I found also on the forums. It is not Kursk. It seems to be one of the last elephants that defended Berlin. And probably people put their best wishes on it. And yeah, it is recreated by historical photos. Very interesting skin. Yeah, we are in the vehicle, driver position. The scope is a bit different, but same rules apply for those triangles and the distance between the triangles. You don't see the range indication, but on the right, if I change the range, you see there's a UI element because the range setting is here inside, not depicted in the scope. in the optics. Guess not. Guess it will start a spawn when we move forward. Oh wait, something is happening there on the horizon. No, that's just trees. Question is, do you need to hit the waypoint exactly on the spot? Because I didn't drive right into the dust, into the smoke. Oh no, okay, it's fine. Hold. 2 mils somewhat, 1500. Either a bit too short or it impacted. But I guess it was too short. Okay, that looked like an impact. Range a bit less, more. 1600. impact that is somewhat 2 mils, should be the same. Impacted 45 degrees, 4 mils, this might be divided by 1.5, yeah, 2 mils, 1500, 1600 cent. Seems like we missed, but let's continue on those guys. Yeah, 2 mils, same distance. Was it over the top? I mean, some of them stopped, could be that their AP shell went through. Not a tank is not supposed always to burn or whatever when it is killed. It's rather unsafe, but I think I see he's spurring up the engine. At 50 meters, it seems like it's going below the tank. Might indicate that we are hitting ground. Now they're reaching 3 mils. Let's go down to 1200. Yeah, 3 mils, somewhat 1000 to 900, yeah, 900 to 1100. At 50 more. Too right. Three mils, 900, or 1000, aber das Start was 900. Aim for the hatch. Stopped, but nah, he's fine. Flank 8 mils, 4 mils, somewhat like 700. It's not entirely 8, he's sitting at a degree, at an angle, so let's go up to 850. Front almost exact 2 mil, mils, might be 1500. Catastrophic. Something like 2 mils, he's on an angle. 1500 and a mass. The rush of the. But nice training. Yeah. Yeah, 2 mils, 1500 cent. Somewhat 2 mils. Because 500 looks good right now, they're all similar distance. Bit too low, but impacted, it seems. At 0.5 something for lead. And now he stopped. Sent a mass in the turret. Catastrophic. Let's train on those 4 mils flank. So 2 mils translated. Let's add 2 mils lead. That was way too low, way too little. Another one. Yeah, let's try out. Yeah, something like 6 mil lead. That's 8. 8 is better. Because you need to give the gun also some time to send the shell. Yeah, this thing sliced through it. So if some of them are not misses, some of them are simply go through the tanks. It looks like a miss. Okay, this Jimmy is also at 1500, somewhat like this time, 8 mils. Almost. Did the trick. Let's train on some long range targets. 1.75 mils. Might be something like 2000. Too low, let's add 100 more. Seems like but I like it that it is hard to observe hits. I think in reality it is not that easy. I know it from shooting AT weapons. It can be sometimes, sure, if something explodes, but not everything explodes. Some stuff simply will stop functioning. And in most tank games it is rather easy affair to observe if you're hitting or not. I don't think that this was an easy affair in reality. Which might also explain why you often see, yeah, that was definitely a hit. Why you often see those vehicles that are absolutely pierced into submission, but you can tell those vehicles were already destroyed but still somebody fired on them because they couldn't tell, is it destroyed? Yeah, what is that? I mean, this gap here is quite helpful. But in the Zeiss optic you have those small triangles. Small triangles are 2 mils. So it is a bit more cumbersome in this one, I think. Yeah, almost exactly 2 mils, he might not exactly, because he has an angle. It might be 45 degrees, 1 mil, divided by 1.5, okay, this is something also 2000 meters. Start simply with a bit less what we have now. No, look good, a bit too low. Additional 50 meters. I guess it impacted the ground and then impacted the vehicle without enough energy to penetrate. that looked on spot. Right between turret and hull. Two mils, but at almost 45 degree angle, same. Should work with the same setting. I guess they are sitting at the same range, and this. But we will still measure them out in order to train this. Because in reality, you can't tell. No, in reality, if we play the mission. Yeah, let's drive a bit away, or let's close in and let's train drive on shooting. I mean, most of those things are destroyed, but I want to see how good the performance is of this. Let's go down with the scope to 500. Let's start there. Good, let's start with this vehicle flank. Five mils. Translates to 2.5 mils, that is something like 1,000 meters, but we'll drive closer, and then we can test it out. Yeah, that was a hit. And this thing is almost exact 2 mils, go 1,000, but we need to keep driving in mind, let's go with 1,400. Was blown up. Yeah, it seems like this vehicle is fighting quite formidable on drive. Normally, fighting targets at 1,400. I mean, we are talking here about really big engagement distances for regular tank combat on the drive. Not bad. That is quite a precision. Would be the scope really that smooth while driving? I'm sure the head perhaps stabilizes, but I think that is so smooth. Perhaps I deactivate the head shake rate. Let's see, is that a thing? Let's see. No, not really. No, not a thing. Yeah, I mean, I welcome it. But it looks really extremely smooth. I mean, we are on smooth ground, but still, that drove is a tank. Alone the vibrations. Yeah, okay, so now we are reaching tank with 8, 9 mils, 4.5 mils, that is something like between 500 and 700. At this distance, with these calibers, you can simply go 500 and center mass. I think it sliced through. This distance, of course, you can aim at weak spots. Like hatches and turret ring. Somebody fired on me, or was it the explosion? No, 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 something is going on here. Let me perhaps get inside. Identified. Basically this guy here. Let's aim for the hatch. But with an 8-8 at this distance, you need not to aim for anything. What happened? Normally a Sphinx should blast into pieces. That's a bit low. Okay. Yeah, what is this? 3 mil? No. Yeah, 3 mil, 700, but I guess it is more like 800. Didn't penetrate. Yeah, 3 mil, same. You can also use other... And you can also use incoming shells to tell the distance. Because if you know, most of them regular AP rounds travel at a certain speed. And by the time it will take to reach you, also by the ballistics, you can tell the distance. But that was in reality a rather difficult affair. I don't know if, I mean, those tank shells, you can see them, but especially at daylight, if they were always that visible. Six mils, 3 mils, 900. That's strange, so feel our offset. Hey Packrat. Awesome, yeah. 7 mils, same distance sent, but we have some offset because of reasons. It's yeah, okay, he's driving Giffit. Okay, now he stopped again. Fire. That those guys looking. Look at this. Was this in the beginning already? That they had those face, those the dust on the face. In the beginning they were clean, but I don't know exactly. Would be a nice feature if they would start to get more dirty while operating those guns. You know, it was pretty sure not a safe workplace in the tank back then. All those, I guess, a lot of stuff was. I mean, sure, they tried to get it out of the fighting compartment, of course, otherwise it would absolutely impact your fighting capability, but I guess not everything could get it. Okay, yeah, that was a training mission, I guess. Nice one. Good training with the turret. The gun. Drive a bit around. Just want to give it a bit more time. Let's see what some certain features. In the worst case, we need to take over every position. Yeah, I don't know, I looked through periscopes. I mean, they give you a vision, but this looks like a LCD screen. Like a Samsung LCD screen. I mean, for video gaming it is fine, because in video gaming everything is... What? In video gaming it is simply harder to see than in reality, in my opinion. Because the eye is working different than a computer screen, and also because graphics are different to reality, of course. That is really a nice clean vision. Okay, that was a training mission. Ah, yeah, what makes sense, and perhaps that's why it's called Ferdinand. Because Ferdinand Porsche. That's, yeah, that is, I think that makes sense, because Panzer III is, I mean, sure, they could use parts, but it's way too small. And, yeah, the track and everything. And they then at least provided them with the Ferdinand project, because you always need to balance your industry, you know. Henschel, I think Henschel, yeah, won the Tiger competition. And but you need to watch out that some people don't become butthurt. And of course you need also to give to hand out projects in order to keep them busy. This would make sense, yeah. And you don't need to start from the scratch with everything. And the would make sense. I mean, later they called it Elephant. But yeah, here, beginning or the official name was, I don't know if it was official Ferdinand, but I mean, it is known like this. So yeah, it would make sense. I think I read something like this, yeah. Good, we are now, I mean, this won't be part of this episode, but after our training, we will now relocate to the battlefield. Yeah. And we are hopeful we will cop. Yeah, that is, I love it. We will always say hopeful we will cop. Yeah, very good. Hopeful we will Karl Müller cop. And yeah, we will participate in the Kursk operations. Yeah, here, Porsche Tiger. Confirmed. Okay, I'm already excited to continue, because this campaign remakes a very good impression. And yeah, it was great to have you around. See you in the next episode. Good hunting.